by Hand's Pike, which takes you down to, eventually down to 17. And there's Mosier and McDaniel and Wells. Calvary Christian Church back through there. Fall is setting in. The trees' leaves are turning. Life is beautiful. I'm going to turn to the right here onto the old Taylor Mill Road as we go by the Taylor Mill Swim Club here. This is sort of the heart of Jim Mosier's district over here. Great legislator. Welcome to Taylor Mill. We'll go by the beautiful picnic grounds down here. Wayman Branch Road and Taylor Mill off of this side over here. Going by the Allison Rose Funeral Home on the left. Beautiful park here where we had the Oak Ridge picnic. Oak Ridge Baptist Church picnic, and where we had the Schaefer-Worthington reunion. Schaefer reunion. Welcome to Pride Park. Beautiful facilities there. And what's the gentleman down here on the left that lives here, Jim?
Mr. Philip Resnick.
Mr. Phil Resnick, great man, great teacher. And Donna Resnick, who's gone on to heaven here. And here we are at Wolf Road. This is where I grew up. My first, I guess, decade of life. Wolf Road. Little cottage here for sale. By the way, I'm still a real estate broker. 52 years. 52 years. This is my last year. And there's where Dudley Martin grew up. Going on to heaven. Sherry's still here. And the Halberstadt's here. Gary Halberstadt. Hobart Halberstadt. And there it is right there, June. Slow down just a second. Oh my goodness, you're going to pull right in here. You're really getting brave. Now this is where I grew up, folks. I've been here and showed you this house many times. 3589 Wolf Road here. I got an S out on the front, so it could be Stephenson. But it's probably the name of the people here. And that garage was added on to the house. And, but I remember standing out there on that porch with Mayor Ruth when we walked home from Rosedale Swimming Club, yeah, barefooted and all, and up Taylor Mill Hill. We got separated from my brother Gerald, and who grew up here, and sister Mary Ruth, who grew up here, and Barbara, who grew up here, riding back and forth to Eastern Kentucky to get her teaching degree, which she taught for 35, 40 years. Bless her heart. This is Barbara Brander Stephenson.
They had fixed up really nice.
Beautiful cottage here. And but anyway, we stood there on that porch, and a reporter took our picture, and that's the first time I made the front page of the Kentucky Post, back when I was 5 years old. June's going to back out now so we can go down this time.
Try to.
We're going to go down over the hill. That's where the Hope Williams live next door, and the Culbersons live next door to Hope. Normally I pull in their driveway, but June is so nice to pull in here for me so I can get a good picture here of the place. And Hobbs and Mrs. Culberson used to be our great neighbors that we loved to pieces. And down over the hill, you see the top of the house there, where the Williamses lived, Ricky Williams and the Williamses. Oh, they had Trump signs up through here too. Good, praise the Lord, glad to see that. Oh, I don't know about that sign. And there's where the Exlers live, Bill and Bobby Exler, great basketball players. And we rode our bicycles. I never forget riding Gerald's bike over this top of this hill. It was no fenders, a no fender old bike, riding down through here, and the brakes overheated on me, and I'll show you what happened to me. Oh, mercy, was it ever some memories. Coming down this hill on that bicycle, and just imagine, flying down through here, and the brakes, and you think everything's going to be okay because you got brakes. Well, they got hot, and the brakes were useless. And I was about useless. Oh, mercy. And if you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, and a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. Nice. Well, you can look right across the road there. Yes. There I come, flying on that bicycle, not knowing whether there's a car out there or not. Turn to right. And there it was. That railing wasn't there to catch me. I was right on the front porch of that house. And believe me, crashed.
That must have hurt.
That hurt my feelings. It hurt my body. And but I'll never forget it. And I tell you what, it was a day. It was a day to remember on Wolf Road Hill. And Wolf Road, back over down there was the pond we used to swim in and fish in.
Welcome to Ryland Heights.
Ryland Heights. Yeah, it's beautiful out through here. Oh boy, days there on Wolf
Looks
Road.
Looks like they're putting in either new lights. Yep.
Yeah, putting in something new lights here. Looks like. That might be. I don't know if the railroad tracks are. No, that's not the railroad. Uh-huh. Railroad's down on the other side.
It's kind of interesting.
On the left side.
Wood. It's all wood.
Yeah, putting wood up through there.
Not quite sure what that means.
I'm not sure either.
Ryland Heights.
Ryland Heights here.
Last time I was with you, we went that way.
That's yep.
For that reason and for that reason.
Yeah. And here you see the old roads, too.
2047.
Junction 2047. And
where does that go?
I'm not sure, to tell you the truth.
Do we want to find out or not?
I know.
Better not.
Some other day. Okay. This is going up the old DeCourcy Hill here, though. I can remember riding a bicycle up here. Beautiful day to ride up through here. Beautiful day. This, if you stayed on this road, it takes you all the way out to Kenton Baptist Church, where I grew up there after we went on from Wolf Road. We were going to Taylor Mill, or to Latonia Baptist Church. That's where Mom and Dad was, and Uncle Pete, Cousin Pete Bingham. He was Sunday school superintendent there, and Brother Shelton and Brother Huff, the ministers. And the minister down there now, I think, is still, what's his name, June?
Is it Dan Francis?
Dan Francis,
is he
yeah.
Still there?
I think he might still be there. I see Geneva, or his wife's Jean. Is it Geneva?
Geneva.
I seen her on Facebook the other day. She's a wonderful lady. I think she's a school teacher, too.
She retired.
But retired, probably. But going up here, this takes us up to, I think, where the lake is up here. I might be wrong about it, but I think the lake is up here, if my memory's correctly. I remember taking my picture up here with the kids. And what a wonderful picture it was. Yeah, turn the radio and get WIOK on there. 107.5 FM on the radio dial. Thank you. listen to WIOK 107.5 FM on the radio dial. Tri-State Gospel, Gil and Jan Hammond, Stewart's, Falmouth, Kentucky, Post Office Box 50, 41040, zip code. Now, if my memory sets me right, right up here is about where we had a picture we took across the way there.
Tegan and her friends,
yeah.
Spent the weekend.
That's where the picture was taken, right there, of the beautiful valley. Oh, beautiful. And right down here on the right, I believe, is the lakes here. Oh, there's the lake right there. I want to get a good shot of that. Yeah. Beautiful. That's one of the lakes. I think there's more lakes down here.
Ryland Heights City Building.
Ryland Heights City Building there. On the left. Been in there many a time singing. Places, if you can pull over there, we'll get a shot of that view, June.
Well, I think we lost that opportunity back there.
Well, I think I got one down here at Ryland. Now, up here is where I think the lakes are.
My car's behind me, bud.
It's okay, I can shoot out the window here.
Nice.
Got the fishermen out there fishing. Kim Mosier sign, fantastic. start over here. Okay, going down the hill here.
Rough road.
And we'll turn left down here before, just about halfway down here.
To what?
To the Ryland Heights. See it pop up here.
Here.
Yep. Island Lakes and Country Club. To me, this is one of the prettiest places. Beautiful trees and the river, the little golf course. Just a beautiful place. I've sang down here many a time. Functions, gatherings, prayed with people, sang with people. Private property, no outlet.
Who do you know that lives down here, or did live down here?
Was it? I'm not afraid to say because it might not have been them.
So pretty. It's very
beautiful. Oh, it's beautiful. Beautiful. This is the country club right here. And down there singing many a time. Meetings. At 81, you've been a lot of places. I turned to my right here. Beautiful place. Puppy here. Little bridge over the railroad tracks. I think we can go over across that. Turn left.
Yeah. I'll pass.
Oh.
Well, I'm adventuresome, but I'm not that adventuresome.
I've been up there.
I trust that you are.
Beautiful back through here, though, isn't it? It's a nice ride. Show respect for those people that have their private property, so. But when you got a place of this beautiful, there's always going to be wannabe picture takers like me that share the beauty with everybody else.
I'm not going back there because that's a private driveway.
Okay.
So will this take me around back?
I think this will take you around. I'll go around the whole thing here, I think. If not, we'll go back out the same way.
Yeah. I think I have to turn around about.
Just don't go all the way around?
No.
No? Okay. Well, just turn around. Very pretty.
It's so nice because it's like being so remote so far away, and it's a stone throw from everything.
Everything, yep.
It's really nice. That was a private drive.
Yeah.
And that bridge is going over to a private drive. That's why I don't want to get there.
Yeah.
What a gorgeous day for this.
Beautiful day. See the lake down through there?
Back up in there.
I got a picture of it. That's okay. Yeah. That's got it. Traveled with Dr. John Stephenson and June Guyman Stephenson today. Pleasure to have her drive.
Do you think the days can get any better than this? This is a God-kissed day.
Beautiful day.
How are you doing, sir?
You got a beautiful friend. You got a beautiful friend with you.
Yeah, I do.
Nice to meet you, John Stephenson.
How are you?
I used to be Superintendent of Education for the state of Kentucky.
Where are you?
The last elected one. Now, I know you some from somewhere.
I don't think so.
What's your name?
Very educated. We got a car.
What's your name? You live here?
Yeah, right there.
Okay.
Have a good day.
Out walking his dog, huh? Beautiful golf course here. Of course, it's a private golf course, but I imagine somebody here, you probably got a friend in here that would invite you to come down here and play golf with them.
Of course, here goes the train tracks right there.
Nicely done.
Yep. You see up on top of the hill there, the building? Turn left here. Okay.
Because of, you know what? I think we better start.
Heading on home? Okay. If you say so.
Well, let me just say we don't want to be in a situation.
I understand.
So when I get up here, do I want to go left or right?
I go left.
Okay, and where's it
going to
take me to?
Well, if we want to, we can go on out Kenton Station and then turn right and go up over the hill.
Are you going to be able to?
Yeah, I'm okay. Yeah, I think I'm okay.
Are you sure
about
that?
Yeah, I think so.
Because remember, there's nothing here.
I think I'm okay, hon. Beautiful here.
Stunning.
Yeah, it is.
It really is stunning. Kept up really well. Mailbox is privately tucked in there.
Yeah.
So, so pretty. Sure, it's interesting when it snows.
Yep. Okay. Well.
Maybe not.
You could probably see better than I can.
Yeah. So pretty.
Yep. Beautiful, isn't it? Case Road.
What was it?
Case Road, C-A-S-E. Believe it or not, I've rode all these roads on the bicycle out to Kenton Station.
It's the perfect weekend
for camping. Yeah. Take 536 back up then.
Just in case. Didn't realize that Ryland Heights was that close to the Visalia Bridge in Campbell County. I mean, it was across from there. But are you okay this way, or you want me to go straight?
Well, I would have gone straight, but I understand.
Speak.
Straight. I guess you know what I want to see.
Oh.
The old Kenton Baptist Church.
Of course.
Where I grew up.
Well, I hope they have an outhouse for you.
There's still an outhouse behind it, I think.
With snakes?
Probably. Yeah, we went to Latonia Baptist until we moved out onto Martin and Mulford Roads, which you'll see a little later here. And, when we moved out to Martin Road, the house is no longer sitting there. You can't see it. You can see the house that June and I built up on the corner of Martin and Moffat Roads, our beautiful farmer home. But you'll get to see the little church that Judy and I and Mayor Ruth and Gerald and Barbara did never attend this church, I don't believe. I think she was married and teaching by then, living with Jay Brandner, World War II veteran, for many, many years. Both of them are now in heaven. There's the old railroad tracks. I used to work on the L&N Railroad back in the 60s, and my dad worked on the L&N Railroad for 30-some years, retired from there, and his father worked on the L&N Railroad. In fact, his father was crushed between two cars back there when we saw him and talked about the DeCourcy Yards and the southbound hump. That's where Dad worked, and that's where I worked, and that's where my grandfather, Dad's father, was killed when Dad was just 5 years old, crushed between two cars there. June and I have got a picture of my dad as a little boy and his father. And we met one of the relatives of the Stephensons, I believe, the other night at the Anchor Church. I'll get into that more a little later here. But a wonderful lady who was raised in a children's home and found a lost long relative in me and had a revival there at Anchor Church with Randy Wallace when I sang and brought some messages. There's Conley Road. Now we know where Conley Road takes us out, but we'll go by that probably later. All the way out to Kenton Station here, where there were four deacons, Walter Roden, John Grizzell, Vernon Likens, Carl Covey took Judy and I, Judy Lynn Felty Stephenson, first grade teacher in four different states, lives up in Cincinnati, up above Cincinnati, on Morris Road, I believe is the name of the road where she lives now, with Don Felty and their family, Donnie and Ethan, and Elizabeth is out in West in the United States, her daughter, and out there with, I think two or three children, and a husband out there, and I think Washington State, but don't hold me to that. I think that's correct. But now we're going through right beside the railroad tracks all the way through this out here, and this is where it takes us to Kenton Lakes up here, where I used to do a lot of fishing. And there's the St. Matthew's Church. Pray for them. I've been there. Wonderful church. And, you'll see what we used to call Reimer's Lakes up here. Charlie Reimer's, I believe it was. And the lakes now are sort of dried up, I think, if I remember correctly. But those four deacons and Walter, four deacons and Brother Kerger and his wife Polly took us kids down to, that's part of the lakes right there, I think. And then you'll see the Kenton Baptist Church come up here. June wants to turn right here first, and we'll go down and see the new church in just a minute. But here's the old church right there. And pull in there a second, June. Let me get a little picture. Yeah, there's an outhouse still back behind there, June. And there's the church. And I'm okay, yeah. No, I'm fine. And there's a little one-room Baptist church. Mom was a pianist. Mrs. Roden was a pianist. And Brother Kerger was a pastor. And Foley was a pastor, one of the pastors here. And later in life, his daughter, Pat Foley, I hired when I was Deputy Secretary of Transportation, Commissioner of Motor Vehicles in Kentucky. She had just got her law degree, and I hired her there to work for the State Transportation Cabinet. She worked there till she retired. Wonderful young attorney, wonderful young lady with a father that was a great gospel minister, Brother Reverend Foley. There's a little church, and you'll see the new church now. Mom died before the new church was built, but she knew about it. And she knew, and Dad turned the first shovel over with the other deacons. They have a picture of that. Right on the other side of the road, of course, is the lakes. We'll pass those when we come back by here. But we'll go on down and show you the new church now. And that's when we were taken down to Louisville, Kentucky, to hear Billy Graham speak. And Judy and I gave our lives to the Lord and the Billy Graham Crusade. 1956. Whew, that's old. 1956. And that's where I learned the song, I'd Rather Have Jesus, and How Great Thou Art. Now here is the new Kenton Baptist Church, Speak Life. And this is where Dad turned the dirt over, and they built a new church here. Wonderful little church. June and I have come out here visiting many times, praising the Lord for them. Prepare to meet God, that's it. You'll hear the word of the Lord there. The minister there is excellent, superb, a great revival person. And it's a great church. If you live out here in this territory, come on out here, be a part of this church. And I'll tell you what, if you're just visiting, you want to see a wonderful Christian people, come and be with them some Sunday morning or Sunday evening or Wednesday evening. It's a great, great group of people. And let's see now. Over there's the dog.